A very essential part of working with surface controllers is to have some available data. In our case, in this chapter, we will be working with data from our form on our website. Now, in this video, we'll be setting up the model, which will define the data that we will be working with. A model is basically a class with properties. It defines the data that will be submitted via our form, and it also defines how this data will be validated. The data that we define in the model is the data that will be passed between the view and the controller, both of which we will be setting up in a video later in this chapter. Let's take a look at the form we have on our website. The form has a total of 6 fields: article title, summary of the article, an upload field for an image, a text area for the article itself, and then there are 2 text boxes for some details about the author. Now, all these fields, they will map to the properties on our model. So let's open Visual Studio and first make sure that the solution isn't running. There we go. Now, in the Solution Explorer over here, right-click on the Models folder and select to add a new class. Name the model article model.cs and make sure that the Visual C# class is selected and click Add. So in our model here, let's go ahead and create a property for each field we saw in the form. We'll start by creating a property for name. So let's say public string name get set. And for our summary, public string summary, and again, get set. The next one we'll create will be a public IE numerable for HTTP post file base. And this one will be our featured image. So get and set. And I need to post that file base. There we go. All right, the next one, public string article content. Again, get set. And the final 2, author name and author title. We've now defined the data that will map to the fields on our form. Most of it is simple text strings, and then there's a single IE numerable object, which is the image. Now, in some cases, you might want to add more advanced data types like rich text, numbers, or something third. Check out the Going Further video at the end of this chapter. Well, I'll give you some tips on how you can build in this tutorial and customize these models to fit your needs. For now, our model here is almost ready. The final thing we're going to do is add some validation. We'll set both the name, article content, and author name as required. So we'll write required here. There we go. And I believe we need to add a system component model data annotations. Yes, so that was name, and we'll add it to article content and author name as well. Now, this ensures that the form cannot be submitted without data in at least those 3 fields. Now, we will also ensure that the name of the article, which will also be the name of the content node in Umbraco, that this can be no longer than 200 characters. So we'll say max length 200. There we go. And that was it. We've now created the model and defined the data that we'll be working with for the rest of this chapter. In the next video, it's time to set up the view.